friends, welcome back to my channel. This is Brindha and this video is going to be all about pimples or acne, however we call as. So today we are going to discuss only about pimples, the tips, the do's and don'ts of pimples. It's been a month since I started this YouTube channel and this is my first skincare topic that I wish to touch. Because with pimples, I have some real-time experience right from my childhood. So at the earlier stages of my life, I suffered a lot from acne. So now my skin has been changed from oily to some combination kind of skin. Always your skin type can change with ages. So now my skin has been transferred from extremely oily to some combination type of skin. There are a lot of reasons which causes pimples that could be because of some hormonal issues or genetic problem or due to diet or even the medication. Some of the medications can trigger out the pimples. So the reason could be many. Dermatologists always compare the pimples with the tip of the iceberg because the problem always lies within, inside the skin or within your body. So in this video, I'm going to be telling you some of the tips of the pimples and do's and don'ts when you get pimples. I know this is going to be really, really useful for you guys, because this is all the things that this is all the information that I have gathered with my real-time experience. So please do watch the video till end. So now let's move on to the video. The first point is that please do not touch your skin, because your hand always encounters the grime and bacteria which can easily get transferred into your skin, which can in turn result in the pimples, because the pimples are always the bacterial infection which occurs on your skin. So it can be more prone to people who have extremely oily skin. Please avoid touching your face more often. If you feel any kind of itchiness on your face, just wash your hands and then touch your face in such a way that you can reduce the infections getting transferred onto your skin. The second point is that avoid glycemic diet. So glycemic diet is nothing but a diet which contains more of carbs. So a high carbo food intake can lead to some rise in the sugar level, so which can also result in pimples. In simpler term, please avoid all the junk foods, oily foods, pizzas, burgers. So these are the things which can increase your pimples. So please avoid all these kinds of food. Take more veggies and fruits, so which is always good for your skin as well as good for your health. I know it is very difficult to avoid fried or oily foods completely, and even I love oily or fried foods. I used to have plenty, but just try to cut down these kind of stuffs in your diet, guys, because it's not only good for your skin, it is also good for your health as well. So if you are having oily foods 5 days a week or fried foods 5 days a week, so you can just cut it to 2 days a week, and gradually you can just reduce that to 1 day a week. So in this way you can just replace all the oily foods with fruits, vegetables, nuts and all these healthy diet and healthy fatty foods. So try this, it really works. Next thing is that reduce the protein intake. So this point I'm just telling for guys who are going to gym regularly, who are doing workout, who are taking the protein supplements or protein drink regularly. So high protein can even result to pimples. So just try to avoid more protein in your diet, just compensate with the other stuffs. Also after doing workout, just take a fresh bath, because you'll have a lot of germs in your hands and which can easily get transferred into your skin, so which can in turn result in acne. So if you are working out, please ensure that you take a fresh bath before touching your skin. The next point is that please don't stress out. Stress does not cause the pimples, but if you have pimple, it can make the situation worse, because when you are stressed out, the inflammation will be sent to your oil producing glands to secrete more oil, which can result in more number of pimples. So please don't get stressed out, and there are a lot of alternatives to avoid that. Do meditation, do yoga, do exercise, or even play whatever the game that you like. So just engage yourself in the activities that you like, to avoid such stress, because stress really causes, it really aggravates the pimples. So the next point is about water. We all know the essential thing about water, the importance of water, but we don't follow that. It is very important to hydrate your skin as well as your body. So it is very essential for the people with acne prone skin to at least have 3 liters of water per day, and have at least 1/2 liter of water in empty stomach. So it can just do a magic in your skin as well as your health. So do try this. So if you find difficult to have water in your diet, just maintain some kind of chart in whatever form you like. What I do is that I just maintain a sticky note in my desk, just measuring the water that I have in a day. So whenever you see that, it just reminds you that still you need to have more liters of water. So do follow that, because when your body is dehydrated, again your body will intimate the oil producing gland to produce more oil, which in turn can result to pimples. So it is all it, water also plays a very important role in your skin as well. Do not pop your pimples out. So if you have more pimples in your face, please do not touch it, or do not pop it, or do not play with your pimples. So if you are doing that, I'm sure you are going to result your skin in a scar which will be permanent on your skin, and it is very very difficult to erase it from your skin. So please please do not, if you are a pimple popper, please do not do that. Because it can result in some adverse effects which can lead a permanent scar in your skin. So limit your exposure to sun. So when you are exposing your skin more frequently to sun, again your skin can get dehydrated, and which can result in pimples. Also, the oily skin people, if you are trying to use a sunscreen, try to find a sunscreen which is non-comedogenic and which is fragrance free. So a non-comedogenic product is nothing but a product which does not clog your pores. So try to find such product and then apply on your skin. So the next step is to moisturize your skin. So people say that only the dry skin people need their skin to be moisturized. It is not that. Even the oily skin people needs to get their skin moisturized as much as how the dry skin people would do. So please moisturize your skin. Please ensure that every time you wash your face, you moisturize your skin. Also, whenever the skin is dry, at that point also you just moisturize your skin. It is very important to know your skin type. Oily skin people are more prone to acne, and even the combination skin people can get acne. So a combination skin is nothing but a part of your skin will be dry and your T-zone will be oily. A T-zone is nothing but your forehead, nose and your chin area. So this part is called as your T-zone. So if your T-zone is oily and your rest of your face is dry, then you fall under your combination skin. So it is very very important to know your skin type in order to choose the right skincare products onto your skin. For example, the oily skin people should include the non-comedogenic product in their skincare routine, which does not block their pores. So always better to know your skin type. Next topic is about face washes. So always the oily skin people, what they do is that they wash their face very very often to get rid of the oil. Please don't do that. It is strictly not recommended to wash your face more than twice a day. So please do not wash your face more often, because if you are washing your face more often, it will just get rid of all the essential oil content from your face, and it will make your face more dry, which in turn leads to again more oil production, which leads to pimples again. So please don't wash your face more often. So if you feel some kind of stickiness in your face, you can just use some fresh water, fresh clean cool water, and wash your face. Please don't use face washes more often in a day. Also, it is recommended for oily skin people to use foaming face wash or the gel face wash. Also, it is very good to look for the face washes with glycolic acid or salicylic acid or lactic acid, so which is very good for the oily skin people. So the next point is that please do not try any home remedies. So we can see a lot of videos with a lot of home remedies for pimples or acne. I'm not sure how far it is working on the skin, but to me, please don't try any home remedies to treat your pimples, because some people use garlic in their pimples, so which can result, which can burn your skin out, even the turmeric. So it can work for one day, but for the other day, definitely it is going to result your skin in some adverse effects. So please do not try any home remedy. So instead, you can just try using tea tree oil, which has some anti-inflammatory properties. So what you can do is that just pour some couple of drops in a cotton ball and just place in area where you have pimples. So do not just apply that all over your face, just in the area where you have pimples. You can just pour some one or two drops. And also, even with tea tree oil, before trying to use tea tree oil, just test the oil in your sensitive area. Maybe you can test here behind your ears or in your forearm. So which is very important to do the patch test every time you try a product new. So you can try using tea tree oil, which is good, because I do use tea tree oil. This is the next very important point that I thought I should share. I know pimples are annoying. At the worst, they can result to scarring or black spots, which all of us don't like to be on our skin. So all of us want our skin to be always clear, glossy, but the pimples always result in some scars or black spots, which we don't really like it. But guys, please be patient and consistent. Try to follow all these steps for several weeks. You'll definitely find a difference in your skin. So I just want all of you to comment in my comment box, like, after trying this out for at least a month or two, so if your skin is too oily or acne prone, if you could see some difference in your skin, so please do tell me all about that. I hope you got something useful from this video. If so, please do like, share and subscribe. Thank you so much for watching, guys.